Abortion opens you up to the spirit of death. And it will kill everything around you. And let me explain that to you. Whenever you commit abortion, you have given of death or the spirit of assassination or the spirit of premature death the mandate and the open access to come in and kill, steal, and destroy. Number two, what you must understand is when you commit abortion, God will forgive you, but it's more than forgiveness. When the soul of the child that was aborted will give the enemy authorization by taking that life, that soul of the child is handed over by you to Satan, by Satan the permission to come in and take the life of that child. So the soul and the life of that child is in Satan's custody and will keep coming. So apart from being forgiven, you have to demand the unconditional release of the soul and the life of the child back to its creator, God, so the accuser doesn't hold it against you. And you must dismiss the spirit of death and deny it access from your life. Other than that, spirit of premature death and the spirit assassin will always be around to try and threaten your life. So every now and then, you will see coffins or casket. You find yourself in great VR. And all those are indicators. The spirit of death is still moving around. And it wants an opening. And I declare, let there be no loss of any life around us by the blood of Jesus. And say, I declare there will be no loss.
There will be no loss
of any life.
Of any life
that concerns me.
That concerns me,
domestic or external.
Domestic or external.
And say, furthermore,
I declare
that our children will not be fatherless.
Will not be fatherless.
And our wives will not be widows.
Will not be widows. And no father,
no mother
that concerns us
among us domestic or external
will
bury any of their children
in Jesus' name.
Put your hands together.